July 5th, 1944.
And is Rudy. So Walter P. Mildren was a second lieutenant?
Yeah.
And
Andrew Chongo was a flight officer. That would be one step lower than the second lieutenant.
Okay. And then,
Junior Adler was the navigator, second lieutenant.
Second lieutenant navigator.
Bombardier was,
Donald B. Schofield?
Schofield.
Oh, Schofield. Oh, okay. And he was a flight officer. George B. Evans was a sergeant.
He was a radio operator and
right-waist
gunner,
left-waist gunner. What's that, were you, Pete? You were the right side?
I always took the right side, yeah.
Hey, Grandpa.
Hey, Jace.
Let's go check out these planes.
Hey, look, check out this memorabilia right here.
All right.
Did we have to pay anything?
I don't know. I thought maybe we did, but yeah. Hey, look, for sale. Oh, wow, they got bomber jackets. Look at that.
Yeah, we have to figure.
And the ones with the real heavy ones, ship's king.
Jacob. Oh, look at these hats.
Oh. This is summer.
Hey, you should have brought your hat, Grandpa.
This is summer cap.
Summer?
Yeah, for the officers.
Officers.
My uncle was in on the Air Force.
Oh, the Air Corps.
Air Corps? That's what he was in.
Army Air Corps. Later on, it became just
Air Force,
yeah.
And I remember he wore brown.
Yeah, we had, this was a summer cap, and then the winter cap was a different one here. The archers have a different logo here. This one, this emblem is for the officers.
Line, all right? Okay. Okay. That's a runway.
Go inside, Jay.
Huh? Go inside? All right, let's go for it.
Jacob.
What are you taking pictures of, Jacob? Focus is bad in here.
It's very crowded.
Yeah, it's pretty
small in here.
Pretty crowded.
Oh, and it actually shows how much is left right here as it goes up, huh?
Yeah.
Is one of these for each side of the gun? Left gun, right gun?
Yeah.
Well, that's what it is, yeah, because there's two different boxes right here. So I figure this chain...
One coming up from the right gun, this is two from the left gun.
Yeah.
Thank you, Randy.
And these are from the right gun here.
It wouldn't get stuck with that thing holding it?
Sometimes you have problems with them, but that's what you're paying for to get rid of the problems.
How does it feel to be back, Grandpa?
Feels all right.
You just want to get back there and fire off a few hundred rounds, huh?
Yeah, they got it locked. This is how you charge it. It's around inside the chamber. Firing mechanism here.
Falter. Air tanks. Yeah, yeah. You go through here to the bomb bay. Watch your step. Yeah, like nothing, huh? It's like a playground for you guys back then.
These are 500 pounders.
500 pound bombs?
Here, hold on, Jacob. I'm gonna get
blockbusters.
They call them blockbusters?
That's what they call it. 500 pounds each. Each carry about 8 tons of them.
8 tons?
How cramped these things were.
Yeah.
It didn't bother me at all when I was in them.
Get out of the way, Jimmy.
It was a lot easier back then, huh?
Well, I was only 18 years old.
Yeah.
That makes a difference.
Cockpit here. Wow. Wow, it looks bigger on the outside, you know?
This is the bomber gear.
Yeah? The bomb site?
Yeah.
The inside is so small.
Yeah, it's
definitely. Looks a lot bigger on the outside.
Oh, okay. It's got a panel up there.
Oh,
wow.
Yeah.
There's a little window in there, right?
The nose gear doors are designed to break away. If somebody wanted to bail out of the airplane, all they had to do is jump on those doors, the doors would fold open, out they'd go. Again, stay on the catwalks and avoid the doors. Now, I'm not trying to make you afraid to go anywhere in the airplane, but what I want you to be is situationally aware. It's a World War II aircraft in pretty much original configuration. It's not designed to carry passengers, so you need to be aware of where you step and what you grab onto as you make your way through the airplane. All the control cables are exposed in the airplane. If you're hanging onto a control cable, you're flying the airplane. Pilots don't like that. They're pretty possessive. There's a little plexiglass window in this rear door. The door has a walkway on it that'll support your weight, but the plexiglass window won't. Just basic common sense stuff like that. Once the pilots call for the gear to come down, same scenario. I'm going to come in the back and give you the high sign, or you're going to hear two bells ring. Anytime during the course of the flight you hear two bells ring, that's your indication to go ahead and return back to the seats you were sitting in. Need your seatbelt down for the landing. Whatever taxi work we're going to do until I say it's okay to disembark. Now we're going to do what we call a hot load. We've got another flight after yours. So when you exit the aircraft, you're going to exit through the corner of the bomb bay door right here. When you exit the aircraft, make sure that you either walk out around the tail or walk directly away from the airplane. Never walk towards the main wing. And you've all signed a waiver. You all understand this plane's categorized in the experimental category. Listen, I see his head nod yes at this time. Here we go. Pretty simple. Let's have a great time. Don't fall out. Seating arrangement. Four seats right here at this bulkhead in the waist section. Three seats on the floor. One seat up behind the pilot and the co-pilot. Don't worry too much about where you're sitting. Everybody sits in a disadvantaged place to see anything. That's why I'm going to cut you loose as quickly as possible. Any questions?
Are you flying it?
No, I'm the crew chief on it.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, let's go ahead and get on board. It might be a little bit easier if you walk around and enter in through the other side. That way, I don't believe the rope's on that side. And I need one individual to go up front. Ma'am, if you'd like to go up front, that's a little bit more comfortable seating.
Really?
Yeah. Okay, we'll get this guy to go.
Well, okay. Hey, Grandpa, you want to go up front? Yeah.
There we go.
Take Grandpa here.
Get in. Get right in through the front of the bomb bay right there. Climb up on the flight deck. Guys, we get ready to go flying. We need everybody to start flying on the dog.
Okay.
Back behind the van.
Okay.
What's up, baby?
This would be...
Okay, one of the three, right here, right
here. This is baseball
inside. Oh, I see. All right, here we go. Nice.
There's a place right there to sit, too? That's the place?
There's going to be four of you up along that rear wall down there. It's just a matter of finding a seatbelt, squeezing yourself in.
Oh, wow.
Okay, I'm gonna have to turn this camera off for a bit.
Yeah. I see one propeller turning. One.
Got the whole thing on tape. How was it?
Love it. Love it.
That was awesome.
I wish I could be up here another 5 hours.
Yeah, totally. What is
17.
It? Oh, dude! There it is, flying in. Yeah?
Do you want to wait for this one to land again so you videotape it?
Yeah, yeah. Let's videotape the landing. Wow, look at that thing fly. Yeah. Oh, no. You know what? I had no idea. I didn't know they were going to do so many, but that's awesome. That was pretty amazing. That was so worth it.
Gonna take off again.
That was so worth it.
Red?
Has my camera. Rudy! Take some pictures of it!
Jay, how do you get closer?
Zoom! This. Pull it towards you.
Did we pull it right here?
Yeah, you came in this way.
Oh, look at the gear going up.
That one over there?
You landed this way and then you looped around and came back in this way. You came down this one, right here. It's gonna circle around and then
it's gonna fly right over?
No, it's not gonna fly over us, it's gonna go off that way.
Oh.
They
kiss it.
Not me. Thank you.
Take off, guys.